Hi students, today I am discussing about the topic is viruses. Viruses are unique group of biological entities. These are the special groups. Viruses are unique or special group. Biological entities that infect every type of cells. And bacteria, next plants, animals, and human beings. Viruses are unique group of organisms and biological entities. They infect every type of cells like bacteria, plant cells, animal cells, and human beings. Next, viruses, they are not composed of cells. They are not composed of cells. Cells are absent. Hence, they cannot be seen under the light microscope. They cannot be seen under a light microscope. Next, each virus particle contain a nucleic acid. Each virus particle contain a nucleic acid. The nucleic acid may be DNA or RNA. Only a one type of nucleic acid is present. Both nucleic acids are absent in a single organism. Each virus consists of a nucleic acid. The nucleic acid may be DNA or RNA. Both, they are not present in a single organism. Next, nucleic acid is surrounded by a protein coat called capsid. Nucleic acid is surrounded by a protein coat. This protein coat is called capsid. Capsid is composed of protein subunits called capsomeres or capsomers. Each nucleic acid may be DNA or RNA. They are surrounded by a protein coat. The protein coat is called capsid, and capsid is composed of protein subunits. The protein subunits are called as capsomeres. Sometimes in some other viruses, nucleic acid surrounded by proteins, lipids, and carbohydrates. Some other viruses have only a protein coat, but some other viruses have proteins, lipids, and carbohydrates. This coat is called peplose. Nucleic acid surrounded by proteins, lipids, and carbohydrates. Hence, the layer is called peplose layer, and it is composed of peplomers or peplomeres. Next, each virus consists of nucleic acid. Next, the nucleic acid may be DNA or RNA present in the viruses. Next, the study of viruses is called virology. Virology is a branch of botany. It deals with the study of viruses. Next, viruses are infected. They infect all types of cells. Next, hence viruses are called as obligate intracellular parasites. Viruses are called as obligate intracellular parasites. That means they cannot multiply. Virus particles are, they cannot multiply even in the absence of host cell, or they invade a host cell. The virus particle complete the life cycle only in the presence of a host cell, but in the absence of host organism, they cannot complete their life cycle. Hence, the viruses are called as obligate intracellular parasites. They cannot multiply until they invade a host cell. If the virus DNA enters into the any host cell, they can multiply. Viral DNA occupies the host cell and multiply the host organism and increase and produces most of the or many viruses or virus particles. Virus particles are synthesized only the viral DNA enters into the bacterial cell or any host cell. Hence, the virus DNA multiplies in the host cell and produces many virus particles or many viruses. And after the production of many viruses in the host cell, they destroy the host cell or lysis of the host cell. Destroy or lysis of the host cell, and newly synthesized virus particles are released. Hence, the viruses are called as obligate intracellular parasites. Next, discovery of viruses. Viruses victimizing the mankind from ancient times. Victimizing mankind from the ancient times. For the first time, a Russian pathologist, Dmitry Ivanovsky, reported that an identifiable agent causing the diseases in plants or humans or any other organisms. Ivanovsky experiment conducting on tobacco mosaic disease in tobacco plants टोबैको मोजाइक डिसीज इन टोबैको प्लांट्स आइवनोस्की फिल्टर्ड द सैप ऑफ द डिसीज्ड टोबैको लीफ. ही फिल्टर्ड द सैप. सैप मींस लिक्विड सब्सटेंस. सैप ऑफ डिसीज्ड टोबैको लीफ. However, the disease causing agent is passed through the pores of the filter. These filters are specially designed to retain bacteria. They designed to retain bacteria. Bacteria pattukodani. These filters are prepared for to retain the bacteria. But he filtered the sap of the diseased tobacco leaf. The disease causing agent is passed through the pores of the filter. And these filters are specially designed to retain the bacteria. And he injected. He injected the diseased tobacco sap into the healthy plant. Injected into a healthy plant and observed after the some time the healthy plant is suffered with a disease. And he concluded that a disease causing agent is transfers through the pores of the filter. Next letter, Martinus Beijerinck. Repeated Ivanovsky's experiment and he concluded that the disease causing agent is a contagious living fluidum. Martinus Beijerinck repeated Ivanovsky's experiment and he concluded that the disease causing agent is a contagious living fluidum or contagium vivum fluidum. And the latter, W.M. Stanley discovered the virus. They causing tobacco mosaic disease. They causing tobacco mosaic disease in tobacco plants were crystallized for the first time. The virus tobacco and he named the virus name is called TMV, tobacco mosaic virus. W.M. Stanley discovered the virus that causing the tobacco mosaic disease in tobacco plants and he crystallized the virus and he named tobacco mosaic virus or TMV. And later Frankel Conrad. Frankel Conrad discovered the genetic nature of RNA, or the genetic material of TMV is RNA by using of some experiments like ultracentrifugation एक्सरे क्रिस्टलोग्राफी, एक्सरे क्रिस्टलोग्राफी एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी, इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी, दिस इज द डिस्कवरी ऑफ वायरसेस. Next, classification of viruses. Important 4 marks question. What is ICTV? ICTV means International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses. The full form of ICTV means International Committee. Committee on Taxonomy, Taxonomy of Viruses. This is the full form of ICTV. And ICTV regulates, it regulates the norms of classification. And nomenclature. ICTV regulates the norms of classification and nomenclature. And ICTV scheme has 3 parts. They are family and genus, and last one is species. ICTV have 3 schemes. They are family, genus and species. Next, always the family names are ends with suffix viridae. Family name ends with suffix viridae. Next, genus names are ends with virus. Genus names are ends with virus. And species names are this end with the, species names are in common English expressions. Species names are in common English expressions describing their nature. Next, the virus name after the disease they cause. Virus names are in after the disease they cause. Example, polio virus. Now coronavirus also. Corona is a disease and the disease causing agent is virus. Coronavirus or polio virus. After the virus names are after the disease they cause. Example, polio virus or now coronavirus. Next, in humans, in human beings, AIDS causing virus, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. AIDS causing virus classification is family family, retroviridae, always the family names are ends with the viridae, family name retroviridae, and genus names are lentivirus, genus names are ends with the virus, hence the genus name of the AIDS causing virus is lentivirus. And species name, the species names of AIDS virus is HIV, human immune deficiency virus, or HIV, shortcut form HIV, human immune deficiency virus.